every time we take on a job like this, we tell ourselves we are never doing this again. And here we are, same old song and dance. In this container, we've steel stud framed 16 inches on center, and our customer has asked for plugs every 4 feet all the way down this. And I just came in here, the electricians are hard at work, and I stopped production because this electrical box is pretty much right up against the inside corrugation. It wasn't part of the customer communication here, but I would have suggested every 44 inches we do a plug, because then we can put this plug where the outside corrugation is, and we do get a full 2 inches of foam all the way around this box. So they're actually gonna have to remove all of these. We're gonna run the spreader bars, and then these will be connected where they need to be. I noticed that the electricians were installing all the boxes right up against inside corrugations, but their method of fixing it was using this spreader bar that goes from stud to stud and mounting it to the back of them. That works for traditional housing or instances where you have a thicker stud than this or stud cavity, but here, that is touching now the inside corrugation. That's gonna transfer cold across and into your receptacle. Still a problem, a bit more of a thermal bridge and maybe a little more of a distance, but what we should have used and what we've created, I think we have 500 of these things. We could have potentially installed that there, done a little bit of tin work, and now we could have installed this receptacle through the allotted spot, and wow, that actually lined up very well. So we could have still modified these instead of using that, and now this is all front facing. None of this steel stud spreader bar behind there that's wicking all that cold back into your receptacle. So even up here, you can see that the BX, the armored cable, is touching the ceiling. So now that cold is gonna transfer through all that metal and right into our light fixture. On the very coldest days up here in Canada, we get water dripping out of our light fixture and landing on the floor. Another problem there. So basically all this, it's so clean. All these RAB fixtures here, they have the knockouts right on them, and we can just pipe from one fixture to the next, to the next, to the next. It looks mint. Conduit is super modular and it's adjustable. So if your panel is surface mounted on your interior wall covering and everything's piped in, now you don't like where a plug is or you want to add another plug, your electrician can just roll in, pull another wire, or just tee off in a box and jump up. It's just absolutely the best way, especially for industrial structures like this. So here we have the breaker panel. This thing was up and installed and they just pulled it down. I think their original intention, it was mounted to three studs. They were gonna pull it back, expect the spray foamer to foam there, and then try to put it back on. But all of these wires were sticking out like this and going into the side of the panel. How is a finisher gonna finish up to that with spray foam here? It's code that you need all your spray foam covered. So all these wires should have collected into a junction box. We can come into the back of the junction box. They all could be looped with excess cable. And then once everything's all spray foamed, we tape off the box, we would finish the wall and then install your panel and conduit down in. It'd be super clean, super tidy. We've done this before in previous mods. I don't know why we're going back in the past. So what we recommend is surface mounting all the wiring with conduit, and don't pull all this BX, all these anacondas through your wall, because you can see the foam's gonna push out on this. You're gonna try to plywood this afterwards, and you can't just push the BX back into the foam. Some people think, oh, well, while it's wet or something. No, the foam cures within 10 seconds. It's like fully cured in 60 seconds. There's no such thing as that. Some people would think, oh, if you're just gonna use a fiberglass or mineral wool insulation, then this will work. Don't use that. It's not meant for shipping containers. You definitely want the vapor barrier that a spray foam provides you, but you need to be nice to your spray foamers. You need to give them access into things like all these corners, up at the top corners, behind your panel. There's so many times I see people who try to recess their panel right into the wall. They have the back of the panel touching the corrugation. Every one of your breakers is gonna have a huge amount of frost on them. That's gonna light your whole container on fire. It is super dangerous. Do not do it. Just popped in on the guys fixing up this container to get it ready for spray foam. And here's an instance where it's wrong. This BX cable here needs a condensation loop to go down into this plug. And so we'll have to either pull a new wire or whatever. I guess here's a good, better example of it. Right here, the condensation can't feed all the way down the line and then into the box. It's got basically a trap up here, and that's code. And And condensation is something that we need to consider when working with containers, because containers are a prime candidate for condensation being a steel structure. And so a lot of this wiring, we want to keep it away far enough from the wall, but not so far that the foam pushes it out and now we can't finish. And what we've done here is we've actually taken half inch conduit and we've ran that through a lot of the electrical holes and used some chicken wire and wired everything up. So this is our bush fix for this job and hopefully allows for that nice gap of foam behind all the electrical, because as power travels through these wires, it's hot, it's creating heat. And so if these wires are right up against the outside of the container and all the foam's here, that's gonna condensate and all your water is gonna drip right into your electrical. Water and electrical do not mix. So let's see what else they've done right here. This thing is pretty much ready for foam and this wire is sticking into the envelope. This is a prime instance of the problem with this. It's so easy for us just to miss this one wire. And if we don't grab, you know, a chunk of chicken wire or something and tie all these together and we miss this, we're not gonna be able to put our plywood right over this. Here's another problem, and it's going to be a problem again. We did this on a previous job where inside the corners, the electricians pulled the wire too tight and it doesn't fully round the corners. So then our guys come in and I don't know why they're using like an oscillating tool or a sawzall or something to chisel away the foam, but they did. Say hello to my little friend. And they cut right through the wire. We lost an entire circuit. We didn't even discover it till after a lot of the interior was finished. So we actually had to pull off a ton of the panels, fish a whole new circuit through. They lost a lot of money there. Notice here now, there's only one light fixture. The other three are missing. I made Travis remove them, because a lot of the BX, it was run on top of the studs and it was touching the roof. The roof's the worst part and the most prone to condensation. If there's heat running through that wire, that's gonna condensate and that wire is gonna drain all that water right back into the light fixture. And these light fixtures here with the clear diffuser on them, it's so common that I see this where there's water stains and there's water dripping from the lights. And I never knew why that was, but now with this condensation loop being part of the code, I'm not an electrician, but hearing that totally makes sense. It's a huge problem. For the last 12 years of modifying containers, every light fixture in a unit that's not spray foam properly, I've seen the damages and the repercussions of it. Here we just got one wire feeding it. We've made sure that we've tucked it nice and tight in the stud. We are gonna get 2 inches of foam around that, so that'll be good there. And then we're just gonna pipe right out of the ends of these fixtures to the next one after it's all said and done spray foamed. This way, this customer might be plywood lining this themselves afterwards, and if they have to do that, they can just pull the one fixture down, plywood everything, and then all the other pipe fixtures can just kind of all screw up at once. A lot of these boxes, we had to move them to be on the outside corrugation, so that's kind of tidied up, and we've done double strapping, make sure that these studs aren't twisting, because if spray foam grabs a box and twists it, you can't just move it back after. Everything is locked in and it's done. And so you gotta make sure that you really go over your entire container and make sure everything is ready for spray foam. There's a piece of plywood here in the panel and we switched all that out to these two junction boxes. They got covers. Sticker should be the inside, but all the wires are all spooled up inside of here. They all come in the back. We're gonna be able to get spray foam all in behind here. And then once that's all said and done, put the panel back on after spray foam. We'll come right out of these into the panel and you won't see any wires. You'll be able to plywood up to all of this, install your panel on the plywood, and everything should pass code there. So if we cut the studs at the right place where all these circular holes in the studs line up, we could pipe through all the studs into handy boxes. That's probably the only way to really get electrical inside your framing and have all this perform and function the way that we want it to, because yeah, it's just a ton of work. I think future project managers that work for me and engineers, please watch this video. I really want you to know how much work this is, and it's basically like twice as much work, double the cost for customers. So customers, this isn't the best. What we'd really like to do is just frame the entire envelope, give you the maximum width inside of here, finish the interior, and then Travis rolls in and pipes in all the electrical. It's all surface mounted. It's all modifiable. It's adjustable. You can add circuits, plugs, whatever, wherever. It is the way to go. This is what we came up with to fix this. We're gonna see it after it's all spray foamed and how it all looks. Hopefully none of the wires are poking through. Well, here it is, all finished up. Turned out okay. A lot of the plugs and the switches and stuff are a bit crooked, but all in all, way better than it could have been if we would have left her the way it was and stray foamed everything in. So we locked all the studs in place nice and straight, and it turned out okay. But if we're to do this again, we're gonna try piping all the electrical inside of the stud cavity. So we've recognized this problem before we've spray foamed. We're gonna do absolutely everything we can to make it right. And mark my words, after this is all insulated, we're gonna have 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 different problems that we still have to solve because of this. And that is the reason why I do not recommend wiring inside of these 1 5/8 steel studs. Always surface mount all of your conduit. And future channing, watch this video, listen to yourself this time.